Hi, and welcome to our FizziQ Junior tutorial. This tutorial is split in three parts: an introduction to FizziQ, including a warm-up exercise, the functionalities of the student's notebook, and the functionalities for teachers. Now let's start and discover how FizziQ can help you conduct exciting inquiry-based science experimentation lessons with your students. FizziQ Junior has three objectives: help students aged 7 to 12 years master the basics of scientific reasoning, introduce them to the use of digital tools, and finally, assist teachers in creating and carrying out inquiry-based sessions in class. To achieve these objectives, FizziQ Junior uses the often unsuspected possibilities of tablets and smartphones to create an innovative learning tool to use in class or at home. For students, FizziQ Junior is both an experimentation tool and a digital experiment notebook, which they will use to organize their reasoning using text, photos, drawings, or experimental measures. For the teacher, FizziQ Junior is the best way to find and prepare inquiry-based science activities, share them with their students, and correct their work on the tablets. The application is free and without sharing personal data. It can be used without internet and works on Android or iOS devices. If your tablet or smartphone does not contain FizziQ Junior, I suggest you download it now by searching for FizziQ Junior on the Android or iOS store. To familiarize yourself or your students with FizziQ, we suggest to do a small icebreaker, a little game on colors. Launch the application, then in the menu that appears, press I test my instruments. Now press the icon entitled The Painter. Follow the instructions to play this little game that will test your ability to quickly identify colors around you. There you are. You have now identified the three colors, and you may have realized that a tablet could easily be transformed into a very precise measuring instrument. FizziQ Junior offers access to over 20 different types of measurements on sound, light, movement, orientation, heights, and more. Students can add all these measures to their science notebook to conduct real-life science experimentation. Let's discover these instruments. Return to the previous menu and press the Discover the Instruments icon. You will then see the list of all the measurement tools available to your students to make new and exciting experiments in science. Welcome to this second part of video. In this section, we study the functionalities of the FizziQ Junior workbook and the use made of it by the students. Access to the workbook and the activities is done from the main menu. Press the student icon to access the four main functions that students can use: carry out an activity, create a new notebook, manage existing notebooks, or share their work. Students can start their work from a new notebook, but most often, they will use an activity created by the teacher and available directly on the tablet or downloadable in the form of a QR code. In this session, we will upload an activity by QR code. This activity was created by our team, but we will see in the next part that it is very easy for a teacher to modify an existing activity or create their own activity. Many other activities are available on our site, and we will see later on where to find them. Press on I start an activity. Then on, I download an activity, then scan the QR code that appears on the screen. You have now scanned the QR code of the activity, and the experiment book has opened directly. In this notebook, the student will answer the various questions from the teacher, circled in grey, by adding their answers. Before doing that, though, the student will fill in the box containing the name, date, and authors of the document. He can also add a photo by tapping the icon. Now it's your turn to fill your own notebook. And don't forget to add a picture. Once the header is completed, students will add answers to the different questions that make up the activity. You will notice that the notebook is structured according to five main stages of scientific reasoning: question, hypotheses, experiments, results, conclusions. This structure allows the student to acquire the fundamental concepts and to better structure his reasoning. We will see that teachers can modify these steps in the activity. To add an answer element, students press the plus sign at the place they deem most relevant. They can add text, a photo, a drawing, or a measurement using one of the instruments we described in the first video. For example, let's add a comment, then a photo of where we are. What we would also like is to measure how noisy the street is and add the measurement to the experiment notebook. To do this, we open the sound volume instrument. Then, when we are ready, we press the icon representing a page and the plus sign. The measurement is automatically added to the notebook. You can move any entry in the notebook by tapping on that entry and then dragging it to the appropriate place. FizziQ Junior offers many other possibilities that we will describe later in this tutorial. As for your students, rest assured, experience proves that they will discover these features on their own very quickly, and sometimes they are the ones who will show you new features. At the top right of the experiment notebook, you notice a drop-down menu bar. It contains several tools to manage the notebook. First of all, the magnifying glass, which allows you to have an overall view of the document. Also, you will find a star button, which is a help button to complete the document. This aid gives advice on how to better organize and complete the science book. Finally, the exit button, which allows you to close the workbook and save it. Students' work is constantly saved as they complete their notebook. Even if they quit the application, or if the tablet turns off, their work will be preserved. Once the notebook is finalized, it can be shared, either in the form of a PDF document that can be exported by all the means of communication available to the tablet email, SMS, WhatsApp, Drive, or other. The document can also be placed in the teacher's locker, who can consult it on the tablet in the teacher space. We will see this feature in the next video. In this third part, we will explore how to identify, upload, edit, and share activities with students. To open the teacher's space, we will return to the initial menu of the application, then we will activate the teacher mode with the toggle button at the bottom right of the screen. On first use, this menu is accessible to everyone, but the teacher can create a password to prevent students from entering this menu. Press the teacher icon. The new screen offers the different features of the teacher space, activity search, activity management, teacher locker, and tablet setting. In the Manage My Activities menu, you can create new activities or download existing activities using a QR code. You can then modify these activities to suit your needs. We have also created a database of resources which you can access directly from the app. These projects have been tested in class by our partners. Press the Find an Activity button and discover the many activities which you can adapt as you wish. This feature requires internet access. Select an activity by clicking on its name. You can view the details of the activity, its author, and a link to the complete resource that describes the activity. To access this resource, you press the link and it appears on the screen. From there, you can also download the activity so as to modify it or create a QR code for your class. Press at the bottom on Download Activity. This activity appears in a menu similar to the student's workbook. In this workbook, you can modify the activity, add text, photos, or measurements, but also add steps to facilitate students' reasoning. I now suggest that you press pause and download an activity to your tablet, then modify it with the editing tools. For example, you could add another text box with your own instruction. Once these elements have been added, the activity can be shared by pressing the share icon in the drop-down menu. There are several ways to share an activity in FizziQ Junior. The simplest way is to generate a QR code, which will be scanned by students in FizziQ, either by beaming it on a video screen in class or by printing it on a sheet of paper or sending it by mail. If you do not have internet access, or if you prefer not to use a QR code, you can also place the activity in the student's locker. Students will find the activity in the student's space. Now that you have added a new comment to your activity, generate a QR code by pressing the share icon on the right of the workbook, then select QR code without internet and press the share icon on the bottom right. You can also take a photo of this QR code with another device. Now we will check that a student can read the QR code, return to the student menu, and scan the QR code from your email on another device. You will then see the activity you created appear. There are many other functionalities available in the teacher's menu, such as the exchange of notebooks between the student and the teacher. You can find the details of these functionalities on our website. Before we leave, though, we would like to mention the parameters menu, which allows you to customize your device. This menu allows you to consult the sensors available on the tablet to calibrate certain instruments, such as the sound or the compass, to create passwords, or to personalize the tablet. We advise you to look at these different options and to consult the instructions for use on our website. This concludes our training session on FizziQ Junior. We hope you have found this training useful, and we invite you to look at our website to find more information.